Welcome back, everybody. We have more now on Donald Trump and his very bad legal day. So our panel is still with us. Sean, here is a list of what happened just on Tuesday with regards to those sort of surrounded, who please, surround the president.
Please don't gloat.
Okay. I'm not gloating. This is a shocking day. Michael Cohen, the Trump former personal lawyer and fixer, pleads guilty. Paul Manafort, the former campaign chairman, found guilty on 8 out of 10 charges of financial crimes. Representative Duncan Hunter, one of the first in Congress to support the president, and his wife indicted over allegations of misuse of hundreds of thousands of dollars of campaign funds. That comes just after Representative Chris Collins, another Republican who an early endorser of the president, in fact, the first one in Congress, was charged with insider trading. We also have the White House advisor, Larry Kudlow, reportedly hosting a white supremacist. And then there's the continuing coverage of the former White House senior aide, Amarosa Madigault-Newman, and her tell-all book from within the administration. So what is it, Sean, with all of these people who are attracted to the president? That's just on Tuesday. I mean, I could go back to all the rest, but just on Tuesday.
Okay. First of all, a lot of this, half the details that you mentioned didn't happen today, but in terms of the three...
Well, no.
The three...
I know. The only one was Chris Collins, but that was
relevant. Attacking Kudlow is something that hardly any reasonable person that watches the news or any economist or reason... I mean, you just don't do that. He's not... But back to the actual prosecution, if you're going to have a bad day... Have it all at once. So somehow, I don't know if DOJ plotted this together, but it was a brilliant day. It was like 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
And it's a shame for each of the individuals. But I don't have a lot of love for Manafort. Okay. I don't like the Russians. I don't like the Russian-Ukrainians. I don't like the money that he got. None of that smelled good. And as far as I'm concerned, good riddance of bad rubbish.
Okay.
I'm Cohen. Who would hire a guy like that?
Donald Trump would hire that guy.
Well, I know. I think he's learned from his mistakes.
Oh, yeah. He hired Amarosa as well.
That's not the story.
In 2014, Trump tweeted this. Entrepreneurs, set the example and you'll be a magnet for the right people. Great leaders determine the teams they assemble. That seems pretty good advice, Dave. And maybe it's an explanation for what's happening with President Trump.
Precisely. I mean, look, let's not forget, John, this has been an enormously head-spinning week. Just yesterday, we were talking about Don McGahn, the chief White House counsel, spent 30 hours with Bob Mueller's investigators, right? Mm. I mean, that's a bombshell in and of itself. And then you've got this onslaught of news today. I mean, the reality is this is a catastrophic week and, frankly, a game-changing week for this White House, for the, I think, a significant downturn, I think.
Okay. Areva, to you... Connect the dots here between Don McGahn's 30 hours of testimony to the special counsel and what we're hearing today, you know, from Cohen in particular about, you know, the campaign violation, the campaign finance violation and other testimony.
Well, I think what this is demonstrating, John, is that people in Trump's orbit know a lot of information about him, what he was doing, what other people in his orbit were doing, and they're willing to talk. McGahn apparently wanted to get his story told to the special counsel because he was fearful that Donald Trump would try to throw him under the bus and make him the fall guy for the Comey firing. We know that Michael Cohen also was very concerned that he would be the fall guy for activities that he engaged in with Donald Trump. So people are no longer willing to sit back and be kind of the, you know, the doormat that Michael Cohen said he would be for Donald Trump. You know, the I'll take a bullet for him. That guy has left the building. The new reality is people realize that this president has been engaged in some you know, criminal or near criminal activity, and they don't want to be the ones that are subject to criminal prosecution because of the president's activities. And they're willing to come forward. They're willing to tell what they know. And in Michael Cohen's case, they're probably willing to try to strike some deal to avoid jail time.
Democrat Congressman Jerry Nadler tweeted this out. If, as Michael Cohen testified in his guilty plea, his felonies were committed at the direction of Donald Trump, then the president of the United States would be part of a federal crime. The only thing limiting the Department of Justice from prosecuting being an office of the legal counsel ruling saying a sitting president cannot be indicted. So, in other words, David, the president of the United States, according to this opinion and the opinion of many others, is an unindicted co-conspirator in all but name only.
Well, you know, when Ken Starr was the special prosecutor and Brett Kavanaugh was one of his top aides, they took the position that President Clinton could be indicted. They recommended that the House impeach Clinton, but they said, you know, it's really your lucky day because we could have indicted you. Now, there's a difference of opinion, and some people hang their hat on that OLC opinion, but, you know, a lot of people think Ken Starr was right and give him his due that Mueller could indict the president. Also, the authorization by Rob Rosenstein allows. This is one of the reasons why the Republicans are angry and the Trumpsters are angry at Rosenstein. But Rosenstein's appointment of Mueller allowed him to investigate and to prosecute, as the evidence may show is appropriate.
Okay, we're going to leave it there, but we have a lot more on this next hour, and all of you are sticking around. We're going to mix it up, approach it a different way. We're going to look at the legal issues and then the political issues. But I'd like to thank you all for being with us and look forward to seeing you at the top of the hour.